The Little Girl, written by Catherine Mansfield. A very good morning to all the students of class 9. Students, when we read this lesson, you will come across a girl who is expecting a lot of love from her elders, especially her father. How she starts feeling negative in the beginning of the lesson and how her thoughts drastically changes with the time when she understands that her father is not that uncaring. In the beginning, she finds that her father is very strict, but at the end of the lesson, she realizes that her father is having a lot of responsibilities on his shoulder, and that is why he sometimes gets frustrated and irritated and becomes angry. This chapter, The Little Girl, is taken from her Something Childish and Other Stories collection. So this is a collection of the stories written by Catherine Mansfield, and this small part, The Little Girl, has been taken from that collection. The story is narrated in the third person by an unnamed narrator, and from the beginning of the story, the reader realizes that Mansfield may be exploring the theme of control. There is a sense that Kezia, her mother, and the servants in the house appear to be the responsibility of her father. And the little girl's father controls every individual, each individual mentioned in the house, with the exception of Kezia's father. Okay, so basically, Catherine Mansfield is trying to highlight a lot of things here. She has highlighted the theme of fear, control, freedom, independence, acceptance, compassion, and change. Why change? Because at the end, the attitude of her father is, however, proving to be very detrimental to Kezia's relationship with her father. She stutters when she talks to him as if she's in fear of him, which might suggest that rather than having a loving relationship or a close bond with her father, she lives in fear. So, let's read this section before you read. Do you feel you know your parents better now than when you were much younger? Perhaps you know, you now understand the reasons for some of their actions that used to upset you earlier. Children, as you grow, you will realize that the actions performed by your parents during your younger days, they may be very strict with you, but you will realize soon with the time that it was all for your benefit. The story about a little girl whose feelings for her father changed from fear to understanding will probably find an echo in every home. So when you read this lesson, maybe it's a possibility that many of you can relate to this, the feelings of this little girl. How her fear changed to understanding, you will see here in the lesson. To the little girl, he was a figure to be feared and avoided. Every morning before going to work, he came into her room and gave her a casual kiss, to which she responded with, "Goodbye, Father." And oh, there was a glad sense of relief when she heard the noise of the carriage growing fainter and fainter down the long road. Now, here, a little girl has been described, her feelings has been described towards her father, that every morning her father would come to her, give her a casual kiss, to which she always responds with goodbye father. And when she would hear her father's carriage growing fainter and fainter, she would be filled with a sense of relief, relaxed, because her father would be gone to the office. In the evening, when he came home, she stood near the staircase and heard his loud voice in the hall. "Bring my tea into the drawing room. Hasn't the paper come yet? Mother, go and see if my paper's out there and bring me my slippers." So, as you read this paragraph, you will find that Kezia's father was very controlling. He was very strict, very controlling on all the members of the family. He would get very angry if he would not get his slippers, newspaper, or anything in the house. So, by this, when Kezia would hear her father, she would be filled with a lot of fear. Kezia, mother would call to her, "If you are a good girl, you can come down and take off father's boots." Slowly, the girl would slip down the stairs, more slowly, still across the hall, and push open the drawing room door. Kezia had no other option but to go down and do as her mother said. She slowly and slowly went downstairs, crossed the hall, pushing herself towards the drawing room door. By the time he had his spectacles on and looked at her over them in a way that they were terrifying to the little girl. "Well, Kezia, hurry up and pull off these boots and take them outside. Have you been a good girl today?" So as she reached there, she found that her father had his spectacles on, and that was more terrifying to her. She reached there, her father asked her to take his boots out, and also, was she a good girl today? "I don't know, father." So she stuttered while answering, because she feared from him. "You don't know? If you stutter like that, mother will have to take you to the doctor." She never stuttered with other people, had quite given it up, but only with father, because then she was trying so hard to say the words properly. See, here in the lesson, the little girl, Kezia, was in deep fear. She could not express her feelings. She could not express herself with clear words, as her heart, her soul was filled with fear, especially from her father. But on the other hand, her father wanted her to be more disciplined and a kind of a perfect person. Good in studies, good in other work and everything. She never stuttered, and yes, she never stuttered with other people, because she had left stuttering a long time back. But with father, it was kind of impossible for her to not stutter. "What's the matter? What are you looking so wretched about? Mother, I wish you taught this child not to appear on the brink of suicide. Here, Kezia, carry my teacup back to the table carefully. Brink of suicide means about to commit suicide." So, when the father looked at Kezia, he found that Kezia is looking so much terrified, as if she's about to commit suicide. So, he told his wife that whether you have taught something to this girl or not, and also instructed her to keep that teacup onto the table very carefully. He was so big,
his hands and his neck, especially his mouth when he yawned. Thinking about him alone was like thinking about a giant. For Kezia, her father looked like a giant. His hands, his neck, his mouth, everything was so big, just like a giant. On Sunday afternoons, grandmother sent her down to the drawing room to have a nice talk with father and mother. But the little girl always found mother reading and father stretched out on the sofa, his handkerchief on his face, his feet on one of the best cushions, sleeping soundly and snoring, as you can have a look in the picture. Her grandmother forced her to go down, have a nice talk with parents. She could spend more time with them, open up herself, share things with them. But whenever she came down, she always saw her parents, one mother reading the newspaper, on the other hand father lying on the sofa, relaxing, taking rest. She sat on a stool, gravely watched him until he woke and stretched, and asked the time, then looked at her. "Don't stare so, Kezia. You look like a little brown owl." She came down, mustering up a lot of courage given by her grandmother. She sat on a stool and kept on looking at her father. When her father looked at Kezia, he told Kezia not to stare so much, as she looks like a little brown owl. Children, why her father called her a little brown owl? If you have ever seen an owl, and if you have looked at his open eyes, you would see that his eyes are so big, and when he looks at you, it looks like that he's staring with his big eyes. So that is why her father called her a little brown owl. One day when she was kept indoors with a cold, her grandmother told her that father's birthday was next week and suggested she should make him a pincushion for a gift out of a beautiful piece of yellow silk. Her grandmother had always taught her the love and care towards others in the family. She suggested her that father's birthday is near and she should make a pincushion for a gift and out of a beautiful piece of yellow silk. Laboriously, with a double cotton, the little girl stitched three sides, but what to fill it with? So, with a lot of effort, she listened to her grandmother and started making a cushion for her father. She managed to stitch the three sides of the cushion, but one side was open to fill it. But she was confused what to fill it with. That was the question. The grandmother was out in the garden and she wandered into mother's bedroom to look for scraps. On the bed table, she discovered a great many sheets of fine paper, gathered them up, tore them into tiny pieces and stuffed her case, then sewed up the fourth side. The grandmother was out in the garden. She wandered into her mother's room and tried to find the things, the scraps that are not needed to fill inside the cushion. She reached the bed table and discovered many fine sheets. She gathered them, she tore them into pieces and stuffed her cushion and sewed up the fourth side. That night was a hue and cry in the house, angry protest. Father's great speech for the port authority had been lost. Rooms were searched, servants questioned. Finally, mother came into Kezia's room. Now, on the same night, there was a huge protest in the house because father's speech for the port authority had been lost. Everything was searched. Every single room in the house was searched, and at last Kezia's room was left, and finally mother came into Kezia's room. Kezia, I suppose you didn't see some papers on a table in our room?
Oh yes, she said. I tore them up for my surprise.
When Kezia's mother asked Kezia whether she had seen some papers on a table in their room, she, with a lot of innocence, replied, "Yes, I tore them up for my surprise." "What?" screamed mother. "Come straight down to the dining room this instant." And she was dragged down to where father was pacing to and fro, hands behind his back. Mother was really surprised and called her downstairs, where her father was moving to and fro in anger and with a lot of tension. "Well," he said sharply. Mother explained. He stopped and stared at the child. "Did you do that?"
"No, no, no," she whispered.
"Mother, go up to her room and fetch down the damn thing. See that the child's put to bed this instant." When she reached downstairs, she looked at her father. Her father was filled with anger. He asked her that, "Did you see the papers? Did you something like that?" She whispered, stuttering. Mother was called and Kezia's father told her to go to her room and fetch whatever she had done. "Bring all those things down. I would like to see." So the whole room was filled with anger, fear. She wanted to run away. She knew that something has been done wrong by her, but she was unable to understand what was that. While it was her father's one of the most important speech that he needed very soon, and that was turned into pieces by Kezia. It was a matter of anger. As her father was a really angry man, he was very angry with Kezia and wanted Kezia to learn a lesson now, so that she could not do such thing in the near future. Whenever or wherever, if any important paper is lying somewhere, she should first ask to the elders, then must do whatever she wants to. She was in deep fear, did not know what to do. She was very quiet and she knew that now she would be beaten up by him. Mother went up straight to the room and brought the cushion back there at the downstairs and showed the same to the father. Now in the next tutorial, you will get to know what happened next. By then, read the lesson and understand the writing, underline the words with their meanings on the top, and also go through with these words and phrases on the right hand side of the book to understand in a more better way. We'll continue this in the next tutorial, and you will get the questions on the basis of the first part of the lesson.